All right, it's back day, people. Day 56 on the natural bulk. I'm surprisingly feeling good. I've had a decent night's sleep the last two nights, which is rare. Recently, my sleep hasn't been good. The last two nights, my sleep's actually been decent. And when you sleep well, you feel like you're on PEDs. That's how important sleep is. I literally feel like I'm on PEDs. I've slept well. When you sleep well, the results and the benefits of good sleep are ridiculous. Like, people underestimate how much better you feel when you actually sleep well. So I'm well rested. Day 56 on the natural bulk. It is day 56. Day 56? Let me double check that. It might not be day 56. I think it's day 56. Day 56 on the natural bulk. And yeah, I'm feeling good, man. Shoulders, time to build massive shoulders. Today I've got a 5x5 on 85 kilo, which isn't too heavy. I've done it before, but it should feel good. 5x5 on 85 kilo, and then next week I'm going to go 90 kilo, hopefully for 5 reps. So first exercise is strict standing military press, the exercise I've literally done for this entire bulk, the only shoulder pressing exercise I've done is strict standing military press. So I'll see you in the gym for that first exercise. Right, first exercise, strict standing military press. I've already done one set, I've got 5 reps. I've done a 5x5, but I want to take one of these sets to pure failure. So I'm going to take this second set to pure failure just to see how many reps I can get. I've already done 5 reps on 85. So I'm going to take this next set to pure failure, see what I get. That last rep was a war in itself. It was a grinder. 8 reps after already doing one set of 5. So yeah, not bad. 85 kilo for 8 strict press after already doing one set of 5. Second set, 8 reps. Last 3 sets, won't film them. I'll just do 5 reps to make sure I get that volume in. Then I'll move on to the next exercise. All right, second exercise. Moving on to side delts now. I'm doing dumbbell side laterals again. The second week I've done these. I went away from them for a while, for the first part of this bulk, really. Other than last week, I literally didn't do any dumbbell side laterals. Now I'm doing them again, I'm back on them. For me, dumbbell side laterals are the bread and butter when it comes to side delts. I'll always go back to them eventually. Like, I stayed away from them for a little bit. I did cable side laterals instead. But now I'm back on them. And they're an exercise that I'll always return to because I believe they're foundational to building the side delts. Thank you. Right, I did 27 reps there, first set. I'll do a heavier set now. I'll go up to this. But I'll go up to the 18 kilo dumbbells, 17 and a half kilo dumbbells. I'll do lower rep, probably 12 to 15. And then I'll go back down again. So starting on lighter weight, higher rep. Going up, lower weight, lower rep. And then finishing with lighter weight, higher rep. And I mean, yeah, I don't think I've explained that properly, but basically starting off light, high rep, going heavy, low rep, and then finishing with light, high rep again. So three sets. All right, second and final side delt exercise. Literally the only other side delt exercise I'm gonna do. Cuffed cable side laterals to finish. I always finish with two sets on this. No matter what I've done previously during the session, I always finish on two sets of this. Great finisher, great isolation movements, really just to focus all tension on the side delt, kill them off. Side delts are an area I'm really trying to improve this bulk this off season. So two sets of this, cuffed cable side laterals to finish. All right, finishing with rear delts as I always do. I'm gonna do, I've already done one set and I've injured, kind of not injured, but I've got a slight bit of pain in the left side of my rear delt when I do an exercise, because on back day when I was doing seal rows, I let the bar drop. I couldn't re-rack it properly and I let it drop, and I think I kind of did something to the rear delt part of my shoulder. But it's not too bad. It's just that when I'm doing the reverse pec deck, there's a slight, I find it hard to lock out. So these reps might look like slight partials, but I'm doing the best I can in terms of range of motion. So range of motion here might be slightly reduced. So don't kind of kill me in the comments for range of motion here. Yeah, so range of motion normally is a lot further back. It's all right, it's not terrible, but just the left side of my shoulder, for some reason, I'm experiencing a lot of pain. And it was because of the seal rows. I couldn't re-rack it properly and the bar ended up pulling my shoulder blade down in a bad position. But it's not an injury, it's just a slight owie. And you've got to work around them. So a lot of people get injuries and they stop training, which is terrible. If you've got an injury, still train, do the best you can in a given range of motion. Don't stop training. Work around and do the best you can. So I'm gonna do one more set here, and then I'll probably do another rear delt exercise after this, just because I wanna feel like I can contract better with another exercise. So do one more set here, then probably another rear delt exercise as well. All right, in these next two clips, my mic lost charge, it lost battery, so I'm gonna have to do a voiceover. After reverse pec deck, I wanted to do two sets of 15 on bent over dumbbell rear delt flies, just because I felt on reverse pec deck I didn't connect as I would have liked with it because of my slight shoulder impingement. So I wanted to do another rear delt exercise. I only normally do one rear delt exercise, but decided to do another really to work that mind to muscle connection and make sure I properly connected with the rear delts. After that, I finished with abs. I did my typical ab routine, which is cable ab crunches supersetted with Superman sit-ups. I'll show you what those are in a little second. But for abs, you know, when you're bulking, it's very important that you still train them. A lot of people neglect abs on a bulk. They don't train them on a bulk. Remember, on a bulk is when you build muscle. You don't build muscle on a cut. You only build muscle on a bulk. So make sure you train your abs on a bulk. Even though you can't see them and you're adding body fat and your abs become less apparent week by week because of the body fat increase, still make sure you train your abs so when you do eventually cut, you can see all the muscle you built on the bulk. It's even more important to train abs on a bulk than it is on a cut. Yet a lot of people neglect them on a bulk because they can't see them and train them more on a cut because they can see them. But you're only building muscle on a bulk, so it's more important to train abs on a bulk than it is on a cut. But yeah, guys, today was a tough day. I was tired. I didn't feel like training. And sometimes I'm in the gym and I find myself questioning myself, thinking, why do I do this? Why do I even show up? Why don't I just be normal and go to the pub? And then I remember, I don't want to be fucking normal. I want to be different. I enjoy being different. I don't want to be like everyone else. The pain I feel in the gym will never, ever compare in the slightest to the pain of normality, to the pain of just being another guy. I want to be better. I want to improve. And that's why I go to the gym every day. And I show up no matter how I feel. Anyway, guys, please subscribe to this channel. Follow me on Instagram and TikTok. My name on those platforms is Nick_Hijazi. Nick Hijazi, the founder of the Mendez Cartel, signing off. And as always, long live King Charles III, and God bless Sir Winston Churchill.